Hello everyone, my name is Taiwei Li. I'm a functional consultant at RetroPoint Retail Team. Today I'll be showing you guys the quickest way to set up web services in Business Central. So there are many applications and areas in Business Central that require web services. We're not going to go deep into each features and functionality in this session, but I would like to show you how quickly we can have the initial web service set up and have it running. In the future session, we will be talking about some more detailed setup requirement for a particular areas in Business Central. There are three key steps of setting up web services in Business Central. The first step is we need to set up the SOAP service. Next, we need to configure web service setup. And the last step is test connections. So let's dive into it. The very first thing, as we mentioned, is we need to set up SOAP services. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open the BC admin console, and then we're gonna choose the correct server instance that we're working on. We're gonna scroll down and find the SOAP service section. We wanna make sure the enable SOAP service box is checked. If you don't have that check, please edit the page and then have that check, save the page, and go up, restart your server instance by right-clicking on the start button. Once the SOAP service is set up, the next step is we want to open Business Central and we want to go to Web Service Setup. You can use the search bar on the top, Web Service Setup. Then we'll open it up. We want to check the Web Service is Active Boolean field. Once you have that checked, some of the field will be populated for you automatically. We need to remember the server name, which is quite important. So let's copy that. The next step we want to do is we want to go to web services. So let's type in web services. And then we're going to insert a new record in here. For the new record, we want to insert the following information. So we're gonna use a code unit. And then we're gonna use code unit 9900-9510, which is the web service. And it gives us a message saying the service name cannot be empty. We can paste it in the service name. We copied it from the web service setup. From the previous step, and then we want to make sure we check this published checkbox. Once you have that check, you can move it up and down, and then you can see there is a SOAP URL being created. So let's copy that. Now let's go back to web service setup. So now we're back at the web service setup page. As you can see, here is a field called web service URL. We're gonna paste it, the URL that we just copied from the previous step in. We're gonna hit enter. So you can manually set this up by entering your computer name, server portal, server name, and computer name here, and it will generate this URL for you. However, I find that this way is the quickest and the easiest way to do. Without entering any information, you just need to grab it directly from the web services page. Once you have that check, let's go ahead and test the web connection. And we got this error message saying the remote server returning an error, not authorized. That mostly because you need to enter a credential at this section, the client credential. You want to override it. So here is what we're going to do. We're going to click check this box, override client credential, and we're gonna type in a user ID, password. Sometimes you need to put in your domain name in. And now let's test web connection. Now we got it. Tested successfully in a very short period of time. And that concludes the whole setup of web services in Business Central.
Thanks for watching this RetroPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.retropoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.